you to Emmett and Darby for recording this, and Mary for organising everything. It's lovely to be here. We've played in Dublin a few times, but never at the Hugh Lane Gallery, so it's amazing to be in this space. Also, thanks to Chris Marwood, who set up this National String Quartet Foundation tour. We've been all over, been to Sligo and Wexford and Waterford and Cork, and this is the final leg here. And we began with Purcell's Shacony, which would have been played on viols in the 17th century, but it was brought into the 20th century to life by Benjamin Britten, who made this quartet arrangement in the 1940s. We're now going to move on to Mendelssohn's quartet, Opus 12 in E flat major. This was written in 1829, and at this point, Beethoven had just passed a few years prior. Mendelssohn was around 18 years old. But undaunted by the massive legacy that Beethoven left to the quartet genre, Mendelssohn tried his hand already at some quartets. And you may know the Mendelssohn A minor, it's quite a famous one, the Opus 13. That was actually the first quartet he wrote, and this is the second. There's just sort of mix up with the publishers, that's why this comes first in the sequence. And you'll hear right from the opening bars that influence of Beethoven. If you know Beethoven's harp quartet in E flat, it almost starts identically to this. The other thing to listen out for is the fact that the music in the first movement comes back again in the last movement and finishes the whole quartet. So it feels like you've been on this sort of epic journey throughout and everything's related. The third and fourth movement are intertwined, but you'll definitely know when the fourth movement started. So here's this E-flat quartet.
Thank you. Thank you. cloud drift over the hanging valleys, while streams of water thread through the fuzzy heather. When isolated in the vast landscape and lost within its frozen sense of time, you can't help but be drawn into your own thoughts and recollections. It's a place to cry out, a place to listen.
Thank you.
piece in today's recital. Darby, the recording engineer who's recorded nearly everything, is very excited because he's never recorded this quartet that's coming up next. And there's probably a chance you might not have heard of it or listened to it. If you want to listen to it further, we have a CD, if you'd like, that you can buy online, the usual places. Also the Vampers have a very good recording of it as well. But we recorded that with Ina Boyle's string quartet, which has never been done before, from 1934. But Morin's quartet number 2 in E-flat, it's got that second quartet title because it was only discovered after his death by his widow. He died in 1950, and there's been lots of discussion about when he might have written it or when it was supposed to come out. But there's a good chance that he'd written it a long time ago and he was going to come back to it. In 1949 he said he was going to write another string quartet, and there's a good chance he would have added to this, these two movements that he wrote. They're full of Irish folk tunes. He was in Ireland for a long time, from the 1930s. He also was in Ireland from 1918, after sort of recovering from World War I after he sustained some injuries. And it's probable that he wrote some of the quartet then. The second movement has this amazing fantasy arch to it, lots of different sections, and probably a few tunes you might be able to identify. So here is Morin's very entertaining quartet number 2.
Thank you. Thank you.